This is our third life. We've already had two lives and we're going on from here. My brothers, my sisters, let us understand that the Sharia has come down onto this ground, onto the earth, so that we don't forget who we really are. We are not people who are just businessmen or businesswomen. We're not people who are just getting degrees in a college and getting married to someone on this earth, or just living in a house or just enjoying life. We're not someone who's going to just buy a fancy car in his life and that becomes his goal or her goal in life. As I've said once before, and I'm going to say again, that your car that you've got, please remember, your car will go to the scrapyard and you will go to the graveyard. Your car will go to the scrapyard and you will go to the graveyard. No matter how many cars have come to this earth, they've all gone to the scrapyard. No matter how many humans have come to this earth, they've all gone to the graveyard. So wake up. It's not a place to just live, live and live. It's a place to live and then die. Allah Azza wa Jal said to Adam alayhi salam, when he was sent here as the first human being, he said, you will live here, tahyaun thumma tamutun, then you will die. And Allah said, thumma ilayhi turja'un, then to him, to Allah Azza wa Jal, will your return be. My friends, once we have had this world, and we, like the Sahabi radiallahu anhu, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he said, Hanzala was the one, he said, Messenger of Allah, when I'm in front of you, when we're in front of you, we feel like Jannah and Jahannam are in front of our eyes. This is the hadith in Bukhari. And then, Messenger of Allah, when we go to our families, عَافَسْنَا الْأَزْوَاجُ وَالْأَوْلَادِ, when we mix in with the children and our families and our wives, that's when all what you've said in front of us and the feelings we've had start to disappear. And Messenger of Allah, we don't feel the same, so I feel like a hypocrite. Now, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to tell him that he will have a moment like this and a moment like that. Now, it is okay for us to enjoy the world. Don't get me wrong. It's okay to enjoy the world. But please, don't get sucked into this world to the extent that you forget that this was only one life out of six lives that you've got. Just don't make that mistake. Because when the moment comes and when it's time for me to leave, and when it's time for you to leave, the first thing that will strike me is when the angels come and it's a time for me to wake up, the first thing that will strike me and strike you is what? Is that, oh my God, oh my Allah, Allah, Allah. Why? Because I am a soul. I'm not this body, I'm a soul. That's the first thing that will strike. Oh my Allah, this is now going to be the beginning of the fourth life. Oh my Allah, I was there in Alam al-Arwah, I just remember it like yesterday, we'll wake up. But that's why Tawbah is not accepted when you've seen the angels. Nobody can repent to Allah, nobody can do Tawbah at the time when you've seen the angels. When the angels appear to us at death, that's it, it's finished, game over. Your whole life that you had on this earth was only part of an entire life. And that's when we realize, you know what, I'm now going to go forward and I've got no way to go back. Just like no child born on this earth ever goes back to his mother's womb, the same way no person leaving this world ever comes back to this world. Nobody. And that's it. Now it's the fourth world. What is it? It's barzakh. At the time of death, the soul then is reached by the angels. That time we cut off from the people around us. That time no mother, no father, no brother, no sister, we know. That time is just coming out of the body and it's me, the actual soul itself. And I come out, and at this time what happens is when they put my body in the grave, my soul goes to either Illiyin or Sijjin. This is the life of Barzakh. This is the fourth life. If I'm a good soul, I go to Illiyin. If I'm a bad soul, I go to Sijjin. Both mentioned in Surah Mutaffifin of the Quran. And what happens is a person, when they make this journey and they go there, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us and he's given us good news about Illiyin. Allahu Akbar, may Allah make us of them. Say Ameen. What happens is this. We lose a family here. You know, we guys are so sucked in this world. So sucked. That's my sister. I love my sister. I can't live without my sister. Some people have their WhatsApp status. How do you live without your sister? Well, you didn't live without your sister before your sister came. I'm sure you'll be able to live with your sister after your sister goes or you go. So anyway, so you get so sucked up. It's like you can't, you know, you're so enjoyable. Oh my God, I haven't seen the angels, I've seen the angels. You get so sucked up, you forget about the real life. And then what happens is you lose your family on this earth and you gain another family on the, in the other world. What do I mean?